In this world, so carefully crafted by statistics and numerical outcomes, do you think it's possible to intellectualize our lives lived? Or do our narratives resist the confines of quantification? Although linear storytelling is my Everest, I would still like to take you back to the very start of my story, when a baby girl is born in rural Pakistan to a feudal family. The first words the nurse says to my parents, "I'm so sorry, it's a girl." The community that I was born into respected the general existence of women. But the idea that they would also need a formal education alongside gaining necessary life skills, it was so foreign to them that there existed no academic infrastructure for that. My father, who is an important member of the community, he studied philosophy back in his day. So he decides to break his generational curse and sends his daughters to school. I travel 2 hours to the nearest school every day, through shootings and protests, landmines and floods, and a literal military martial law. I was being taught how to hide in bomb shelters while learning how to do long division. I'd witnessed 4 bomb blasts before I'd even turned 16. But those 2 hours to school, they helped me break another one of my generational curses. My sister and I become the first women in our entire lineage to graduate university. I become an engineer. Every single thing in my life felt like a never-ending series of firsts. Getting employed, leaving the country on my own, getting more degrees, traveling the world, and living on oil rigs in the hearts of deserts and in the middle of oceans and on top of mountains. I would stop and look back at the women I'd left behind and the women I was meeting along the way. And I couldn't connect to anyone. I would nod along to their stories, but I didn't know how to verbalize my own. I found myself craving relatability. And these feelings of isolation were only exacerbated by the professional environments that I was in. There was a running joke amongst my colleagues where they would call me the smartest girl in the room because I would be the only girl in the room. And these feelings led to more and more isolation, more and more seclusion, as the story goes. So, now we're at where I am going to oil fields and I'm working, I have a job, everything is good. So, this is where the part of relatability comes into play. What I have learned in my life is that there is a way to tell these stories through feelings. Fear, joy, embarrassment, even imposter syndrome. We've all felt these feelings, even though we cannot fully fathom what it's like to exist in a life that's not our own. I will give you an example. I felt a lot of excitement when I was tied to a pole and airlifted more than 50 feet from a boat onto an offshore oil rig over shark-infested waters. Now, I understand that a lot of people wouldn't find this particularly exciting, but you know the feeling of excitement very well. So you can imagine the jitters and adrenaline that I must have felt in that moment. One of my most vivid childhood memories is owning this massive calligraphy painting. It had these really bold words that said, "The essence of courage is not that your heart should not quake, but that nobody else knows that it does." I said these words out loud to myself so many times that I became them. Not showing fear was survival. Not sharing intimate details of my life was survival. And the way I was laughing and rosing through life was also survival. But What all of this wasn't, though, was catharsis. These heavy stories and strong vibrations take up important real estate in our hearts, and they demand to be felt, to be shared, and released into the world. So what I said about sharing your stories through feelings, it holds through for everybody in every situation. The art of expression transcends our obsessive need to intellectualize everything onto our resume. The word vomit that comes out of you after an intense experience, that's all you really need to become one with and to resonate with the collective human experience. So today, let's take a leap of faith together. Let's try and drown out the cacophony of the constructs of the modern world. Find the courage within ourselves and just share, just feel, and for a glorious moment, just be. Thank you very much.